What is up, Mouse fam? Welcome back to another video. This past week, I finally got the opportunity to visit Avengers Campus at Disney's California Adventure. So today, I'm going to share with you my thoughts. Since this is a ranking channel, I will rank my favorite 5 things about Avengers Campus, but I'm going to give some general thoughts about the land as a whole as well. So join me as we rank and discuss Avengers Campus at the Disneyland Resort. Alright, so this past week I did finally get to visit Avengers Campus, and I'm just going to break the glass right away, guys. I thought it was absolutely fantastic. It instantly jumped into my top 5 favorite lands at the Disneyland Resort, and right now it is my number 2 favorite land at Disney's California Adventure. I thought it was honestly breathtaking. There are a few critiques of the land that I do agree with. It's on the small side for sure. I don't think it's that small though. It feels a lot bigger than people are making it out to be. And obviously the other main downside is the e-ticket attraction that was announced with it. Supposed to be a simulator type ride similar to Flight of Passage that will be taking you over Wakanda. It hasn't even been given a date, so my guess is probably 2025, 2026 before that opens. So right now the land is not fully open yet. One more critique I will add to it, definitely needs more shade and more shops. Right now there's only 2 shops and there's not much shade. Once they can expand and let the trees grow in, get maybe 1 or 2 more shops, I think the land is really going to blossom and grow with time. Right now, we'll jump into the rankings really quick. Coming in at number 5, my 5th favorite thing about Avengers Campus is the attraction Web Slingers, A Spider-Man Adventure. Now, there's been a lot of slack on social media, if you guys are on Twitter, even a little bit on YouTube, that Web Slingers is not a good ride or it doesn't live up to par. And honestly, I just don't agree with these critiques. I'm not saying Web's a perfect ride. I don't think it's a perfect ride. But for what it's trying to be, I think it knocks it out of the park. I personally think it's better than Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run, which opened in the same way that this ride is opening, not the main attraction of the land. Plus, unlike Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, Avengers Campus does have Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, which is my favorite ride at that park. So it already does have an e-ticket attraction. Obviously, most people will argue the ride's been open for a while, and so it doesn't count. I just don't see that being true. 5 years from now, nobody's going to care when Guardians opened versus when the land opened. They're just going to see it all together. And I think outside of a couple cohesion mistakes that don't fit perfectly, I think Guardians of the Galaxy is a great fit for Avengers Campus. Now, back to Web. It's not supposed to be an e-ticket attraction. It's not supposed to be Rise of the Resistance, and it doesn't need to be. California Adventure has a lot of rides that have a pretty high height requirement, meaning there's a lot of young kids that can't ride a lot of these rides. Web is a great ride for families. Obviously, we do already have an interactive dark ride with Toy Story Mania in the park, but this is just a completely different system. I think the scoring system is very unique. I think the ride system is unique. I think it's got a really cool indoor queue, a great pre-show. Obviously, the ride could have been a little bit better, but for the land that they fit that in, I think they knocked it out of the park. I think Web is a great attraction. I really enjoyed it, and I can't wait to do it again. Obviously, boarding groups is another discussion for another day. Hate it or love it, I don't know if this ride needs boarding groups right now, especially with the crowds. It probably doesn't. But regardless of all that, Web is a fantastic attraction, and I think the Imagineers knocked it out of the park. Coming in at number 4, my 4th favorite thing about the land is Pym's Test Kitchen. For Pym's Test Kitchen, we did get breakfast, lunch, and dinner there, so we got all 3 meals there. We tried out basically everything on the menu. The only thing we didn't get to try is the PB&J sandwich, and I heard that was one of the best items on the menu. So that does stink. We will definitely try that when we're back down there in a couple weeks. The food is a little disappointing. I'm not going to say I love the food. The breakfast was the most disappointing. We probably would not go there for breakfast again. Lunch and dinner were fine. The panini was really good. The pretzel was okay. I mean, it was good, but the cheese sauce they give you with you is literally disgusting. Probably one of the worst things I've ever had at a Disney park. Nasty, but the pretzel itself is fine. We did get the Proton Punch, which I thought was amazing. It's almost like a strawberry horchata type drink. It's really good. It's got a peanut butter flavoring as well. Really good. We also tried the Not So Little Chicken Sandwich. It was fine. Not great. The food isn't what puts it in the top 5 for me. It's just Pym's Test Kitchen in general. I think it's such cool theming. DCA really knocks it out of the park with their themed restaurants. You have Flo's V8 Cafe, Wine Country Trattoria. And I think this is just another notch in the belt. I mean, it's so cool, especially at night. It just looks beautiful. When you get into the restaurant with the pretzel facade, it's just really cool effect the Imagineers pulled off. I think the restaurant just is a great fit for that area. And they have the freestyle Coke machines, which will always bump anything up a letter grade in my book. So Pym's Test Kitchen was fantastic. Coming in at number three is the shows. Honestly, I could put the shows number one. I think the shows of Avengers Campus are fantastic. Now, we did get to see all five, and I'm going to rank those five in another video. But, spoiler alert, we really liked all five, and I thought three of the five were amazing shows. Particularly, the Doctor Strange Sanctum show, the Spider-Man Stuntronic show, and the Dora Milaje, we thought were amazing. We would watch those a couple times a day if we could, and would not get bored. So those are fantastic additions to Avengers Campus. All five shows in general are good. And really, this just kind of speaks to the bigger point of Avengers Campus in general. And this is something that Star Wars Galaxy's Edge really struggles with, that people talk about. There's just so much kinetic energy in Avengers Campus, and they don't even have an outdoor ride. The Guardians of the Galaxy Tower and the Screams do add a little bit to the kinetic energy, but just the shows in general just add so much energy to the land. It gives you so much to do. Honestly, we would probably prefer to just do the shows over the rides in the land. That's how good they are. They're fun for the whole family. They're so unique. They're so different. The Spider-Man Stuntronic show is just a crazy, the Imagineers pulled it off. I don't want to spoil too much because I think you guys should go in blind to these shows if you haven't seen them yet, but all five shows, particularly the three best at Avengers Campus, are just amazing, and it really adds so much to that park. Right now, Disney's California Adventure does not have World of Color or a parade, so there's only a couple other shows throughout the park, and Avengers Campus has five of them. The shows are a great addition to the land, and honestly, a great addition to the entire park. That brings us to number two, my second favorite part about Avengers Campus, the characters. It's going to be hard to describe how many characters are out in Avengers Campus if you haven't been there. If you've just met a character, 5 minutes later, it feels like there's a brand new character out. You can be walking around just trying to get somewhere. All of a sudden, two or three characters pop up. They're on the rooftops. They're on the ground walking around. Sometimes they do a meet and greet. Sometimes they just walk around and say hi to people. My 8-year-old nephew was freaking out. And honestly, me as a 27-year-old was freaking out too. It makes it feel real. It makes it feel vibrant. It also makes you question why in the world all these characters did not go help the Guardians of the Galaxy when they're being held hostage a couple of seconds away. But that's beside the point. The characters in Avengers Campus are just amazing. It really adds so much to that land. Probably 10, 15, maybe even 20 on a good day, different characters walking around. I've never really seen that in a Disney park to this level, and it blew me away. It can't be cheap for them to do, but I hope they keep doing it because it makes Avengers Campus so much better. That brings us into number one, my favorite part of Avengers Campus. Now, normally I would say Guardians of the Galaxy because that is my favorite ride in the park. But since the land is brand new and that's what we're discussing today, I won't put Guardians of the Galaxy number one. So with that being said, coming in at number one is nighttime at Avengers Campus, or more specifically, the lighting package. Avengers Campus during the day is a great, fun land with a lot of energy. Avengers Campus at night is legitimately one of my favorite spots to be in the world. It is just so beautiful. It also starts from the very entrance of the land. It goes all the way back through Guardians. It makes Guardians look way better at night. Pym's Test Kitchen, as I already talked about, looks beautiful. The Avengers Headquarters building is breathtaking. Spider-Man looks great at night. The entrance to the land, like I said, if you've been to Avengers Campus at night, you already know how beautiful it is. It definitely adds to the vibe of California Adventure and makes that park a must-do at night. Once they get some more nighttime shows going at the park, Avengers Campus plus the nighttime shows is going to make it a top-notch nighttime park. So that was my personal favorite part of the land. A couple other honorable mentions that I'll just throw in there that should be of note. The land really does feel true to the movies. There's a lot of different areas, but they really just feel separate. It's obviously a small land. It's just taking up Bugs Land. But they do such a good job of breaking up the lands between Doctor Strange's Sanctum and the Spider-Man area and Avengers Headquarters. They just feel so unique and so different, and that's what makes it great. They do also have the shawarma carts. We didn't get to try those, but they look really cool, and it's just a great throwback to the Avengers movie. Also, another thing of note is Doctor Strange's Sanctum is super cool to walk around during dusk and at night when the show is not going. So if you can, stay and see the show and stay afterwards and walk around. Super cool area. Almost made my list, but it just missed the cut, but really, really great. Overall, guys, I do think Avengers Campus is a fantastic land. Obviously, it's not perfect. It does need that e-ticket. It does need to expand a little bit to make it bigger. But what the Imagineers had to work with, I think they knocked out of the park. Personally, like I said earlier in the video, my second favorite land in the whole park already. And I cannot wait to visit it again. If you guys get the opportunity to go to Avengers Campus, you need to do it. All right, guys, that is my thoughts on Avengers Campus at Disney's California Adventure. Let me know down in the comments, have you been there before? What are your thoughts? Do you agree? Do you disagree? You can also let me know on Twitter if you want, @RankingTheMouse, and we have great discussions over there. Until we see you guys next time, peace.